Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lian Duan, and I have been a developer over 20 years, specializing in DevOps and cloud security. Today, I'm going to walk you through EKS Auto Mode, what it is, its pros and cons, and when it is good for your project. So, what is EKS Auto Mode? It's a new way to run Kubernetes on AWS. With EKS Auto Mode, AWS manages your cluster for you. It's serverless. It scales automatically and even includes built-in load balancing and cost-saving features. Sounds great, right? But is it perfect for all scenarios? Let's take a closer look and find it out. EKS Auto Mode helps simplify your operations. With Auto Mode, you do not need to worry about managing nodes or scaling. It does all of that for you automatically. It's like having a 24/7 Kubernetes operations robot. When you use Auto Mode, AWS sets up and manages the EC2 instances for you. It also applies patches and replaces unhealthy nodes. It's possible because it uses a special AMI called Battle Rocket. However, keep in mind, you cannot use your own customer AMI with Auto Mode. Also, by default, the nodes only live for 21 days before they are replaced. But you can change this setting if you need it. One limitation is EKS Auto Mode has zero-touch policies. That means you cannot log into the AWS nodes. You have to use log to debug, and the developers need to access the log using CloudWatch or ELK stack. Now we have to talk about simplify. Let's move to how Auto Mode handles traffic changing. Auto Mode uses a tool called Karpenter for automatic node scaling. It's great. You don't need to install or configure it. AWS do it for you. But remember, you will pay for convenience. Here is a screenshot showing the price for the reference. However, there is something called code start delay. Auto Mode has two main node pools, general purpose and system. If your app needs super fast response time, like 1 million seconds, you may not need to add support node pool to handle the traffic spikes. But again, this will cost more. There is a traffic surge timeline without support pool example. You'll see how long node ready for EKS. As you see, adjusting your HPA settings can reduce startup delays. If you're not familiar with HPA, check out my video, Hands-on Guide to Horizontal Pool Autoscaler on AWS EKS. Other things to watch out. If your monitoring system fails, you could end up overspending. One way to avoid auto-spending, you can set up a max number of nodes in your spec, like this. Also, please configure bill alert email and message. Does Karpenter really save money? Well, it depends. Let's take a look at whether EKS Auto Mode can save your money. Auto Mode is great for unprotectable workloads. If your app traffic goes up and down a lot, Auto Mode scales to match and helps cut costs. Well, if your workload is always the same, Auto Mode may cost more because it adds additional EKS costs. So, when should you use it? Let's break it down. It's great for apps with traffic that change often. Auto Mode ideal for the startup or team without Karpenter export. If you want AWS to handle more of the heavy lifting, AWS Auto Mode is good. When do not use? It's not great for apps that need very low latency with unprotectable traffic. No ideal if your workload is static. Cannot be used if you need a customer AMI or additional CI plugins. To wrap it up, EKS Auto Mode is a powerful tool, especially for dynamic app traffic or small teams, but it's not right fit for all scenarios. If your app needs static performance, you may want to stick with standard EKS. That's all for today's video. If you want me to cover more use cases or delve deep into EKS Auto Mode, leave a comment below. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.